defending the championship against Roman Reigns.
Yeah, Roman Reigns at one point almost had Rusev beat him. Look at the left-hand side of your screen. A lot of getting involved to save the match for Rusev, but the official made the decision not to disqualify Rusev, but to eject Lana from the ringside area.
And Rusev would take advantage with this massive kick to the big dog and capitalize with the accolade. But Roman Reigns was able to hang on and power out of the submission Rusev has made famous. And then he would turn it into a wicked spear, planting Rusev and allowing Roman Reigns to claim his first United States Championship. The thing about Roman Reigns, man, you get some people who boo, some people who cheer, but the entire WWE Universe is making noise. And lots of it.
My bloodline has been represented in the WWE for a long time. But we've never had anybody win the United States Championship until now. That's because I am the guy. I come out here and I represent my family on a nightly basis, and I do exactly what I...
There is the wife of the former United States champion, Rusev. That is Lana. Where's Rusev? Lana's is out here to steal the spotlight. She is doing a phenomenal job. I picked a great opportunity to do so. She did all she could to try to make sure her husband held on to the United States title at Clash of Champions. You can bet Rusev's wondering where we're going now.
Roman, I've come out here to talk to you, but my husband doesn't know.
Hold on. Lana, come on.
We're in L.A. We're in the Staples Center. There's cameras everywhere. There's like 60 TVs back there, and let's be honest, you're just about the only girl to give Rusev any attention in the whole world. I'm pretty sure he knows exactly where you're at.
Very funny, very funny. I'm laughing. You know, it's really good to have a good sense of humor here in Hollywood when you're negotiating. So I'm here to talk.
We're negotiating now?
Life's a negotiation. So I'm here to negotiate with you. My husband is challenging you to a rematch for the United States Championship.
That's the challenge? It doesn't sound like a challenge. It sounds like he sent you out here to do his dirty work while he hides behind your skirt.
This man is my partner. He is my husband, which means that he is my family. You have no idea what that means. You come out here, you brag about your family, you boast about your family, you talk about how much pride you have, yet you have no idea and zero respect. You have zero respect for a family. You know why? Because you came out here and you tried to destroy and ruin my wedding celebration with Rusev. Wipe your smile off your face, you stupid boy. This is not funny. This is not a joke. This is not funny at all. And my husband will crush you and humiliate you in front of all these people, in front of this country, in front of your family.
You're clearly getting hot. You need to relax. Do me a favor. Why don't you just go to the back, deliver your husband his Bulgarian balls, and tell him to come out here and say it to my face.
Shut up! Shut up! This is my husband you're talking about. You will not talk about that. You will not say that. You go to hell! You go to hell!
Rusev, oh dear.
Here comes the Bulgarian person. And I don't need for the delivery. And Rusev, Roman Reigns can meet each other in the IRA. Here we go. Brothers on the way between the champ and Rusev. The two men who can't stand each other. Now, this has been going on for months. It's become personal. It's become emotional. And now it's become about the United States Championship. Rusev came out here to fight. He's getting a fight from the United States champion. Rusev caught Reigns. That was rolling into the corner. And now Rusev just burying shoulders into the gut of Reigns. Crawling away.
He's got to fight all night.
And Roman drops Rusev with a right hand. Roman's got Rusev in the sights. I don't think Roman's done yet.
Here he comes.
Roman Reigns continuing to right into his knee. They catch him the Adam's apple, right in the throat. Oh, it's driven out of the stance.
No, no, no.
Now Rusev blasting Reigns into the WWE fans. The champion's in trouble.
These two superstars have done battle so many times. They're so familiar. Rusev seemingly has an answer for everything Reigns has attempted tonight.
The one thing Rusev doesn't have, that's the United States Championship. That's the catalyst. That's the catalyst for all this rage, all this anger that Rusev feels.
Possession's 9/10 of the law, Byron. Looks to me like Rusev has the United States Championship.
Again, watch this. Rusev, boom!
Obviously, Rusev is not the United States champion, but Rusev made a bold statement. Rusev wants to hold the United States title. He wants to rub it in the face of every American. He said that on a number of occasions.
Oh, Reigns, though! Reigns from behind with a Superman punch!
Where did Reigns even come from?
I have no idea.
This is where Roman Reigns came from, Corey. Watch the back part of your screen. Reigns across the stage.
Let's start a fight.
Man, if you want me to go to hell, I'm taking you both with me. And you're gonna get your rematch, but it's gonna be inside hell in a cell.
Oh my goodness, the challenge from Reigns. And guys, get them out of your
Mick Foley and Commissioner Stephanie McMahon have to take that under consideration. Finally ending this thing. Once and for all, Rusev Reigns inside Hell in a Cell.
The fact that Roman Reigns is willing to step into one of the most frightening structures in WWE history to defend his United States title is saying a lot.
And the fact that Rusev's going to have to go through that same thing just to get the United States title back is just as crazy. We'll see if that matchup comes to fruition a little bit later on tonight. But ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, we have our own budding rivalry in the Cruiserweight division, which is exclusive only to Monday Night Raw. The Cruiserweight champion is TJ Perkins. Brian Kendrick looks for an opportunity tonight to get back into the title picture. This is the story of two men who grew up together.
And to look at the road and see that this is the only thing I could keep doing because it's the only thing I had.
TJ Perkins wins the inaugural WWE Cruiserweight Classic, becomes the first ever WWE Cruiserweight Champion. TJ Perkins retains the Cruiserweight title. His first title defense, tonight at Clash of Champions.
The Cinderella story continues for TJ Perkins.
Cut you off right there, okay? I keep hearing this Cinderella story business, okay? TJ Perkins, he was homeless. Do you think he sacrificed anything more than I've sacrificed?
Brian Kendrick's gotta be heartbroken. He just lost the biggest opportunity he's had in his career in almost a decade.
Does it feel good having your dream come true? Does it?
Does it feel good depriving me of what's rightfully mine? Does that feel good? Because, you know, that title, it was resurrected. For me. I want you to soak up every last little drop in that spotlight, because the next time you and I, we meet in that ring, that's going to be when we wake up from this dream.
The next time these two men meet in the ring is next. Brian Kendrick looks to fight his way back into this title picture against the Cruiserweight champion TJ Perkins. They go one-on-one. Brian next. WWE Hell in a Cell is presented by WWE 2K17, the video game. Pre-order now and play as Goldberg. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the Staples Center in Los Angeles has taken on a purple hue because the best in the world at 205 pounds and under are on their way. Cruiserweight time, exclusive to Monday Night Raw.
The following contest is to the 4-1-4. You should have picked first from Los Angeles, California, weighing 175 pounds. He is the WWE Cruiserweight Champion, TJ Perkins.
Here's a young man who at 13 years old starting to learn the wrestling industry. In fact, on weekends, he would get a buddy to drive him down the I-5 about 2.5 hours south of Los Angeles, across the border into Mexico, to wrestle in Tijuana.
His opponent, from Venice, California, weighs 170 pounds, Brian Kendrick.
Oh boy, here's a man, Brian Kendrick, who spent a lot of time with TJ Perkins when Perkins was in high school. Brian Kendrick was driving TJ Perkins to learn how to wrestle. He teaches the ways of the business. You can tell Brian Kendrick kept TJP under his wing for a period of time.
Yeah, Brian Kendrick would pick up TJ Perkins as Perkins was, well, going to school. He would skip that day. Kendrick would bring him over to a wrestling school to learn the industry. So tonight it's Perkins against Brian Kendrick. And, well, firing for Brian Kendrick, it's an opportunity to again see a rebirth of his career.
Well, to get what we've seen from Brian Kendrick is that he's willing to do anything necessary to solidify his career resurgence, and of course that means turning his back on his former friend and TJ Perkins.
Well, Brian Kendrick is 37 years old, and from his point of view, his clock is constantly ticking on his career. This could be his last opportunity, and he realizes a win here tonight would put him back in the title picture.
Well, this last time he's got a shook hand, what happened? Kendrick headbutted TJ Perkins.
Yeah, that the following the Perkins victory at Clash of Champions 8 nights ago. And Perkins not going to allow him to get away with it this time, and a drop kick
Rives.
Perkins on the move.
Outside the ring, and TJ Perkins quickly looking to pick up the pace here.
Incredible agility on display in the early moments. And he just dabbed on him.
The Phil-Am Flash. TJ Perkins. Back body drop to Kendrick.
Mentioned it before, the desperation that Brian Kendrick's beginning to feel as his career could be over at any minute. Whoa!
Cross body, springboard off the second rope, and now hammering away on Kendrick, and Perkins did not take too kindly getting headbutted in the face after that matchup last week. You know, Perkins respected Brian Kendrick, but he told me he lost a lot of respect for Brian after what happened in Clash of Champions.
You don't have to respect what Brian Kendrick did, but you have to understand it. This is a man trying to make money, trying to make a living. This is his last gasp at glory.
Oh, man.
Corkscrew clutch over the top of the floor by TJP.
And that's what TJ Perkins is all about. Won the Cruiserweight Championship by winning the inaugural Cruiserweight Classic, which is all the rave this summer on WWE Network. We got the TJ. He was just so fired up, competing in his hometown, competing in the Staples Center, where he attended dozens of Lakers games, and now taking on a man who once served as his mentor.
Oh,
Kendrick caught him with a boot right to the jaw. And TJ Perkins is out of it.
You gotta wonder the nerves that TJP's gotta be feeling right now.
Watch this boot. He's like Kendrick.
He's probably not feeling much right now after the boot to the mouth. But this is the first time in his hometown, his home arena, TJP walks in as the Cruiserweight champion. There's got to be a ton of pressure on him right now.
Oh, my gosh. Shoving Perkins' fingers into the turnbuckle there. If you talk about it, he's patting it.
Brian Kendrick just looking to maim TJ Perkins.
He used almost the entire five count, but again, Perkins is still hung up. Can't get his fingers out of there, and Kendrick is in control. Can Brian Kendrick knock off the Cruiserweight champion live on Monday Night Raw? We are back live on Monday Night Raw. It is Brian Kendrick against the Cruiserweight champion, TJ Perkins. TJ now was on the offense. Brian Kendrick sidestepped him. Kendrick looking for a victory here tonight to get himself back in the title hunt. The Cruiserweight's exclusive to Monday Night Raw.
Uh-oh, watch out.
And Kendrick sent flying by TJ Perkins.
This time Perkins. Not just again, top rope hometown. Boom!
Taking down Kendrick, who really has maintained control for the vast majority of this matchup up to this point.
And Corey, we were actually talking during the commercial break how this is a much different Brian Kendrick than his first time around here in WWE 10 years ago.
Yeah, Brian Kendrick's always been a bit odd, a little bit unusual. Oh! What a kick by Perkins. But yeah, you add this desperation into Brian Kendrick, you got an entirely different, arguably more dangerous superstar.
And there's the quickness of TJ Perkins planting Brian Kendrick, and now the champion's rolling. That high-flying style.
Oh!
Striker as well. Here's the cover on Kendrick. Kick out at two.
Uh-oh.
And looking for the knee bar and submission maneuver.
The submission that won the Cruiserweight Classic and the Cruiserweight Championship for TJ Perkins.
And Brian Kendrick trying to make it to the bottom rope and does to force the break.
And Kendrick knew it was panic time. Had the position been a little bit different there for Perkins, I think Perkins would be the winner of this match.
Well, let's not forget Brian Kendrick with a submission move of his own. The captain's hook. It's allowed him to win a fatal four-way match a few weeks ago to earn a championship opportunity. Oof, straight kick. Well, you guess you could do that too, right? Kendrick face first goes Perkins. And Brian Kendrick looking for sliced bread. Number two, and he hits it. And Kendrick looking to pin the champion. Puts both legs. Oh, and I thought he had it. Perkins kicked at it too.
I think a lot of damage was done to Perkins. Oh.
And now looking at the captain's hook. We talked about it earlier on. TJ Perkins now in trouble. Kendrick's arm is slipped under the chin.
That's Perkins squirming, reaching, trying to get to that bottom rope.
Kendrick doesn't have all of his body weight on the lower back of Perkins.
Oh. And now he might. Brian Kendrick lands. Kendrick's shoulders were down. And that forced him to kick out and forced the break.
Great counter by Perkins.
Oh. And Kendrick floored off the kick by Perkins. These two men so evenly matched. Oh. Drop toe hold into the second rope. TJ Perkins gonna fly!
Wrecking Ball drop kick to the side of Kendrick's skull.
That may have wrecked Brian Kendrick's chances. Uh-oh, Kendrick. Kendrick grabbed the nose, I believe, may have raked the eyes. And now he's got him where he wants him. Captain's Hook again, center of the ring.
A torque on the neck of TJP. Kendrick hanging on for dear life.
Perkins got nowhere to go. Perkins trying to make it to the bottom rope. He's in on Kendrick. Oh. He taps out. Kendrick is tapped out the champion.
You tell me my submission. Kendrick.
Guys, Brian Kendrick has made the Cruiserweight champion submit. Kendrick said he was going to wake up TJ Perkins from his dream. Brian Kendrick may well be on his way to doing so.
And TJ Perkins better just be glad that this wasn't a Cruiserweight championship match.
And we saw the momentum swing back and forth in this matchup. Perkins, watch this. Grab the nose.
Better in the eyes.
And it's Perkins up to a point, the referee, Brian Kendrick, with a captain's hook. TJP with a valiant effort, but he had to tap out. And Kendrick may have earned himself a future championship opportunity.
TJP might feel his Cinderella story slipping away.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, earlier today, I had the opportunity to sit down with Seth Rollins here in Los Angeles, and we discussed a wide variety of topics. Wait till you hear what he has to say about Kevin Owens, as he referred to him as a teacher's pet. And wait till you hear what how he talks about Triple H and Stephanie McMahon. That exclusive interview is next on Monday Night Raw. My guest tonight is Seth Rollins.
Michael, how are you?
Doing great. The question is how are you? How's the rib injury?
I mean, it is what it is, you know. Doctors have cleared me, but they did advise rest, and they advised me not to come to Los Angeles for Raw tonight. But, I mean, you know me. Rest really isn't my thing, and here we are in L.A., and it's Raw tonight.
You know, Seth, this situation with you and Kevin Owens has really escalated since he defeated you to become the WWE...
Look, I don't want to stop you here, but I'm gonna. Kevin Owens may have won the Universal Championship, but he didn't beat me. He was literally handed that title by Triple H. And after what happened at Clash of Champions, I don't really think there's any question, at least not in my mind, that I deserve a rematch for the WWE Universal Championship.
So let's talk about Clash of Champions. Let's talk about the past month, because many people believe Kevin Owens' rise to prominence has paralleled yours.
I get that. I do. You know, I understand why you would say that. You make enemies on the way up. That's kind of just how it goes. You know, I've alienated a lot of people. Pretty much everybody in the locker room, a good portion of the WWE universe. I mean, excluding you, Michael. Yeah, we're sitting in a room with all my friends, and Kevin and I have both had a lot of success here in WWE, but that's where the comparison should stop between us, because how we've gotten that success is two different stories. You know, Kevin's the guy at the office who does half the work but still gets the promotions. He's the kid at school who's like the teacher's pet. He's a jerk and nobody likes him, but he still gets the gold stars. Like I said, Triple H literally handed him the WWE Universal Championship. When I cashed in my Money in the Bank contract at WrestleMania, there was nobody there to hand that title to me. That was me. That was years and years of hard work and sacrifice and dedication put into that moment. That was all me. And everybody's got a Kevin Owens in their life. Just unfortunate for me that I've got the Kevin Owens in mine.
But Seth, your relationship with Triple H has been well chronicled. How do you feel about being replaced in that relationship by Kevin Owens?
Replaced? That's Kevin's word, right? That's his little joke. Redesign, rebuild, replace, that's his thing. Well, I mean, he knows, you know as well as I do and everybody else, that you can't replace Seth Rollins. I mean, Kevin's good and all, but Kevin's just a cog in the machine. And I get it. I've been a cog in the machine. I understand what that feels like. But my eyes are wide open now. I see things completely differently, and I'm going to tear that machine apart piece by piece, and that starts with Kevin Owens, and it starts with the WWE Universal Championship.
At Clash of Champions, Kevin Owens retained the title with the help of his best friend, Chris Jericho. If you get your rematch, how do you see this all playing out?